In today's video, you will learn 9 quick steps how to optimize the performance, get more FPS, and fix FPS drops and stutter in Fortnite on low-end PC. Hey, what's up? I am Victor, and welcome back to another video of this channel. In the first step, you will remove the high-resolution textures in Fortnite to free up disk space. First, open the library in the Epic Games Launcher. After that, click on these 3 dots in Fortnite, and then click on Options, and lastly, uncheck high-resolution textures and click on apply. In the second step, I will show you some settings to make Google Chrome use less RAM and free up more RAM for Fortnite, improving FPS and performance. First, open Google Chrome. Now click on these 3 dots in the upper right corner and then click on settings. After that, select the performance section and then enable the memory saver option. Now select the system section and lastly disable continue running background apps when Google Chrome is closed. In the third step, you will disable the full screen optimizations in Fortnite because this feature can cause performance issues in some computers. First, open the library in the Epic Games Launcher. After that, click on these 3 dots in Fortnite and then click on Manage. Now click on this folder icon under Installation. After that, navigate to Fortnite Game, Binaries and Win64. So now right click on the Fortnite Client Win64 Shipping File and then click on Properties. After that, select the Compatibility tab and then check Disable Full Screen Optimizations. And lastly, click on apply and OK to save the change. In the fourth step, you will set Fortnite's high priority process to make Windows dedicate more performance to the game, getting more FPS and fixing FPS drops and stutter. First, download the high priority Fortnite file using the link in the description below. After that, unzip the file on your desktop using WinRAR. Now right click on the high priority file, click on show more options and then click on merge. After that, click on yes and OK to enable the high priority Fortnite. And lastly, if you want to go back to the default priority, just merge the default priority file. In the fifth step, you prevent Windows apps from running background to ensure that these apps don't slow down your computer and worsen performance in Fortnite. First, press Windows and R on the desktop. In the open field, type gpedit.msc and then click on OK. After that, navigate to Computer Configuration, Administrative, Templates, Windows Components, and then App Privacy. Now double-click on Let Windows Apps Run in the Background, then select the enabled option in the upper left corner. After that, under default for all apps, select force deny. Lastly, click on apply and OK to save the change. In the sixth step, I will show you 3 options that you can enable in Windows to prevent your system from limiting your computer's performance, making you get the maximum possible performance in Fortnite. First, search for game mode in the start menu and then click on game mode settings. After that, make sure that the game mode is enabled, otherwise enable it. Then just select this section called graphics. In the search this list field, type Fortnite. After that, click on Fortnite and then click on options. Now select the high performance option and then click on save. After that, press the keys Windows and R on your desktop. In the open field, type powercfg.cpl and then click on OK. And finally, just select Windows High Performance Power Plan or CPU High Performance Power Plan if available. In the seventh step, you will learn some performance settings on NVIDIA control panel, and these settings can increase FPS and performance in Fortnite. First, right click on the desktop, click on show more options and then NVIDIA control panel. After that, select the manage 3D settings section. Under image scaling, select on and then set 20% under sharpen. Under ambient occlusion, select performance. Under anisotropic filtering, select 2x. Under anti-aliasing effects AA, select on. Under anti-aliasing gamma correction, select on. Under anti-aliasing mode, select off. Under CUDA GPU, select all. Under DSR factor, select off. Under low latency mode, select ultra. Under max frame rate, select off. Under multi-frame sample DAA, MFAA, select off. Under power measurement mode, select preferred maximum performance. Under preferred refresh rate, select highest available. Under shader cache size, select unlimited. Under texture filtering isotropic sample optimization, select on. Under texture filtering negative load bias, select allow. Under texture filtering quality, select performance. Under texture filtering trilinear optimization, select on. Under threaded optimization, select on. And lastly, click on apply to save all the changes. In the eighth step, you will lower the screen resolution in Fortnite to 800x600, increasing the FPS but leaving the game blurry. First, press Windows and R on the desktop. In the open field, type percent local IP data percent slash Fortnite game and then click on OK. Now navigate to saved, config, and Windows client. After that, right click on the game user settings file, select open with and then choose another app. Now select notepad and then click click on always. After that, press the keys Ctrl and F, then type resolution size X and press the enter key. Now under resolution size X, type 1800 and under resolution size Y, type 600. And lastly, click on file and save to save the changes. In the 9th step, I will show you the best graphics settings in Fortnite for low-end PC. First, open Fortnite. Now click on the profile icon in the upper right corner. After that, click on this gear in the lower corner and then click on settings. Under window mode, select full screen. Under VSync, select off. Under frame rate limit, select unlimited. Under rendering mode, select performance, lower graphical fidelity. Now scroll down and under 3D resolution, select 80%. Under view distance, select near. Under texture, select low. Under meshes, select low. And lastly, click on apply to save the changes. And that was the video. If you want to boost and optimize performance in your games, you can subscribe to this channel and then always learn new methods when uploading new videos. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.